welcome, folks, to www.theroadswetravel.ca. I'm with my beautiful wife here, Leslie. Hi, Leslie.
Hello.
We're going to try to do one more podcast before we leave tomorrow morning on our trip for 3 weeks.
Yeah, I'm excited.
You real excited?
I'm getting excited, yeah.
Yeah, we're heading to California. We're going to spend 3 weeks down at Supernatural School of Ministry, Bill Johnson's school, Redding, California. It's called the Bethel Supernatural School of Ministry, I believe. Mm-hmm. Been there before a couple times, and it's just wowed us. And we're looking forward to this trip and coming back just on fire for Jesus.
We should have some good stories to tell.
Yeah, for sure. Mm-hmm. Now, Leslie's got a terrific subject here today to talk about called Prompted by the Holy Spirit.
Well, yeah, when David asked me to pick a topic, it was like, okay, I don't know what to pick. So I said, okay, Lord, what do we want to talk about? And this came in my mind, which came as a prompting. And we have a couple of stories that we can give as an example.
For the past couple of years, I know different times I've been prompted, and sometimes I don't really understand it.
I think what happens is I think we don't recognize that it's God in us that is prompting us to talk to someone or go someplace. And because we are humans walking in this world, we don't often recognize the spiritual side of ourselves, and that it's the inner voice that we're hearing as those little promptings, those little thoughts. We just assume that they're our thoughts. And in some cases, they're dumb, so we don't do them. Yeah. You know, where we start to argue with ourselves and say, oh, that couldn't be true.
Well, we question ourselves.
Absolutely.
For sure.
Yeah.
So first of all, I guess we have to recognize then hopefully be obedient.
Absolutely. So I kind of wanted to start off with a scripture, because I love the word of God, and it's very, very dear to my heart, and it confirms things. So I just want to basically bring John chapter 16, verse 13 to the beginning, where he talks about very clearly that the Holy Spirit comes to guide us.
Yes.
That is his job primarily. But it also says that he doesn't speak any on his own authority at all, that he only speaks to what God wants him to say.
Wow.
So that really spoke to my heart and said, he helps to understand that prompting when you understand what prompting itself means.
Mm-hmm.
Because prompting itself actually means a recollection of our memory. For example, like, oh, I should go and do this. Or, yes, I remember that. Or maybe even a prompting could be a little guidance or assistance. We need some help with some things, or somebody may need our help with something.
Right.
And so we get prompted to help someone.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, there's always the prompting, do it very promptly, quickly. So, you know, but quite often prompting does start simply as a thought.
Yes.
As this thought to either give somebody something or go to help someone or to call someone on the telephone. Anything. It could be as simple or as complicated as God so desires to give it, really.
Yeah, so once we recognize that it is a prompting from the Holy Spirit, then we have to act.
Absolutely. And David, you probably recall the one particular story about Walmart at like 7 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, we were actually in California 2 days before we get ready to return to Canada. And we discussed about buying a piece of luggage because, you know, women, they have a tendency of buying extra clothing, and now they need extra luggage to bring it home. I'm sure that doesn't happen all the time, but...
Truth be known, Dave is actually the shopper in our family, but we'll not tell anyone that.
Anyways, we discussed this probably for a day. And we decided, you know what, we don't really need a new piece of luggage.
I thought it was solved.
We resolved it, no more luggage. But all of a sudden, what was it, 8 o'clock in the morning,
mm-hmm.
all of a sudden I get this prompting from the Lord, from the Holy Spirit, go to Walmart now and buy a piece of luggage. And I just said, Lord, we decided not to buy one. So remember what I said to you.
And the funny thing was, I didn't get the prompting. So I questioned it and said, are you sure? Like, can we have a cup of tea first? And you simply said no.
Lord wants us to go. We got to go now for some reason, I said.
Absolutely.
We drove directly from the hotel to the Walmart. I'm probably only about 5 minutes away.
Mm-hmm.
Parked our car, just got out of the car, and we watched a man, quite a large man, all dressed up, and he was walking across the parking lot, and all of a sudden, kabang, he fell flat on his face. And this was a very, like I said, a very heavy man.
And what had happened was he really, because of his physical size, he was in a position such that he couldn't get up.
Yeah.
And it was very distressing for him, and there was not a soul around except for us.
Well, people were kind of in the distance, but nobody was coming to help. So we immediately, I mean, we're only like 10 seconds away from him. We run to him to give him help. And we yelled out to one person, said, call 911 and go inside and get some help. And
get some assistance from the management team and so on. But I guess at the end of the day, we realized that it was the Holy Spirit that prompted us to go, because this man needed our help.
Yeah.
You can easily dismiss that type of thing.
Yeah, because it took a long time to get anybody to come out of Walmart to even assist in any way.
Oh,
and nobody really wanted to help out in any way.
It was a little disheartening for sure.
Yeah, so we kind of took charge. It was like the Lord knew this whole story beforehand how it was going to play out. And wow, that was a prompting.
Yes. And I think that's kind of what we wanted to say in that, is that we don't always know the end story. We don't always know the reason why we may be asked to do something.
Yes.
So then there's this element of a little bit of obedience that comes in play.
Yes.
Because, again, with the scripture in Proverbs, it simply tells us, trust in the Lord and lean not on your own understanding.
Wow, powerful stuff.
You know, and logically, it doesn't always make sense. And it doesn't always correlate in your mind about, like, well, I don't have time.
Yes.
I don't want to. So then it moves into perhaps a nudge.
Yes.
You get a little nudge about it's, you know, a little more important to do something. You have, again, another story about a little nudge and $500 and sitting in a parking lot trying to convince the Lord. You would give a little extra because of your disobedience.
Yes. Yeah, he had the Holy Spirit said, you have to do this. And I just was hesitant.
Mm-hmm.
And I waited about a week and I was disobedient. I shouldn't say I was disobedient, I just didn't do it right then. A week went by and I was driving back from St. John. The Lord said, you got to do it right now.
Mm-hmm.
So here I am. I'm going to give a little bit of extra money and just so I could, my lack of being obedient, Lord. And the Lord just said, no, you don't have to do that.
Yeah.
You don't have to do that.
Yeah. I'm wondering if the truck shook that day. You know. So we just wanted to kind of share a little bit about, you know, you get the promptings. And sometimes it moves to that little nudge, that little touch, that little feeling that's a little stronger. And God the Father is no different than us as parents in some level where, you know, you try to prompt your children to do a little something. They're not going to be quite as forthcoming. So you kind of push them along a little bit more. And then, of course, you have the final push or pull.
Do it now.
And it's or in one case, we were in L.A. at this time. We had this little pull, but it was a pullback.
Yeah.
And we lost a ticket that disappeared in front of our eyes, actually. It was a miracle in that sense.
I think the Holy Spirit wanted to keep us off the road. We were coming out of a parking garage,
mm-hmm.
one of those automatic ones. You had to have your ticket to get out.
Mm-hmm.
And the ticket, it was on the console. We looked at it when we get in the car.
Oh, yeah. It was right there.
It was right there. This is a very large garage, parking garage, big, big parking garage.
Mm-hmm.
We jump in the car, start it up, move about 100 feet down one lane, get in front of the little place you put the ticket in, and the ticket's gone.
I know.
And it's like, well, where's the ticket? Leslie, where's the ticket? The ticket's completely gone. In the meantime, what I thought afterwards, no cars were coming in,
no cars
behind us.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, you know, to add with the frustration, here I am out of the car, looking under the seats, looking under the back seats, getting so worked up.
Yes, which is very typical, I think, in terms of families and couples, where when something doesn't always go as smoothly as we like, there is that level of frustration that happens.
Yes.
Where in this particular instance, I praise God that we were able to pull back and recognize that the Holy Spirit was pulling us back to protect us, perhaps. Yes. Maybe we needed to be off the road for that 2 minutes.
That's how long it took, a couple minutes. All of a sudden, after we're in the back seat, everything else on the floor, taking everything out, there it appears.
The tickets
exactly the same place
exactly
in the console.
Where it was. So,
and there was no junk in the console. It was a brand new rented car.
It was a rental vehicle.
And nothing in the vehicle. It was totally amazing. And the Holy Spirit, I am sure, wanted us to keep us off that road for a couple minutes, just to avoid something drastic that might have happened.
It was amazing.
Yeah,
it was amazing. And it was a really strong lesson for us, and it's a lesson that we have not forgotten.
Yeah.
And we wanted to share that with you guys today. We just wanted to encourage people that when you do get your little promptings, maybe even your nudge and a pull, you just move forward and you trust in God and you lean not on your own understanding.
Yeah.
And you let God control that part of, you know, that part of your life and allow him to continue to grow in us.
I mean, the Holy Spirit's with us wherever we go.
Absolutely.
Recognize that little prompting.
Mm-hmm.
Recognize that little
pull, that little
tug or nudge.
Yeah.
And that that song, "Lean Not on My Own Understanding," that word is awesome. And
that is a beautiful song, and it's a request for help that you lean not on your own understanding, that you trust in the Lord, and it's like, make me something beautiful.
Yeah.
And as we grow in God, that is our prayer, that we do grow to be beautiful people, that God is proud of us as his children, that we do to please him.
Yeah.
And that's really all he wants at the end of the day, is that we do all we can to be pleasing to the Lord.
Yeah. And we have that song by Leon Timbo. We're going to play this after this podcast.
Yeah, we really hope you enjoy it, and you'll find that he's very anointed.
Yeah.
And a great praise song.
Well, I hope you found this little message encouraging, inspiring. Would you like to end with a prayer, Leslie?
We just want to ask God that those who are listening, that they just are able to hear the voice of God, that they hear the Holy Spirit as he just prompts them to go here and go there,
yes,
and to be ministers in the Lord in any way that they've been called. Some of us are called to be mothers and fathers, sisters and brothers, and we may not see that as important roles, but God knows that your role is always important. And if you have a little prompting, just do it and see the blessings that come from that. We pray for blessings in all people that we've come along to know in our journey, and we pray it for blessings every day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen. And everybody, we're going to see you in 3 weeks' time. May you have supernatural blessings, as Leslie said, and may the favor of God be on everyone in our community and this wonderful, beautiful province. Amen. God bless. Of the maker.
I'm holding on to you. When your word comes, I'm ready for it to change my life. When your word comes, Daddy, I'll never be the same. When your word comes, I'm gonna love like my daddy loves. I'm gonna move when my daddy moves, 'cause he gave everything for me. Thank you for loving me. Thank you for holding me. Where would I be? Where would I be without your love, Jesus? Where would I be without your word, without your word, without your word, without your word, Lord? There's nothing I hold on to. There's nothing I hold on to. There's nothing I hold on to. 'Cause I'm whole. Two.